So, hello, I'm Sven. I can tell you a little bit about me. I have a completely film background, so I'm not really a journalist and not really into programming or some stuff like this. I'm a classical filmmaker. I started with post-production and 3D animation. Then later on, I went to editing in a post-production house. And then I started to shoot my own movies, a little bit documentary, but more narrative movies. And then I come to this point where we, with the company, started to work in VR. And now it's a really interesting part for me because there is a mix between two things I love. I love films, I love filmmaking, and I love games, computer games, but only as a player, as a personal hobby for me. And I think now the VR thing is mixing the two things a little bit together. And so first, I want to talk a little bit about the history. Here you see the Zoo Praxiscope, and it's the first movie ever. Or one of the first movies. There's a lot of discussion which one is the first one, but it's one of the first one. It was just painting on a glass, and when you turn it, the horse is moving. So yes, we had a moving picture, and what they choose to showcase their new technology. It was brand new technology and was like documentary, just a movement of a horse. And later on, we had this one. This is also in the book, the first moving picture with a camera. It's really short because we don't have a lot of things anymore. And you see, it's just people running around in a garden. So there's not a lot of storytelling. There's not a lot of art. And it's just, okay, we have a new technology. What we are doing with this? Okay, let's record something and have this experience, immersive experience for the people, because before they went to theater, they had books, and then later on the photography, but no moving images. And no, later on, this one is one of the first documentaries, and it was a 2 hours movie, so it was really, really long for this time. And also, it was for the military. It was a propaganda movie about how great is the army. So we don't have this movie anymore. I think there are 7 seconds you can watch, but we have a lot of documentation about that this movie was shown. They split it in 2 screenings. There was not, because they was thinking about, oh, 2 hours is too long for our audience, and so they split it. And on the other side, in the same year, we also have this movie, which is a narrative movie, Jean d'Arc. And of course, the color is not the original, but we don't have the black and white version anymore. And what we see when we watch these old movies is that most of them, they imitate theater, what they know. They have the theater, they have the storytelling of the theater, but and then they have the camera, and they didn't know exactly what can we do in a new way. So they record their way of the theater with a lot of what they know about storytelling. And then later on, there was this book coming out. Do you know this book? Some of you. It's Film as Kunst, Film as an Art, and this book is really, really important. It was really, really great because it really, really tries to understand why film could be art. Because at this point, there was a lot of discussion, especially in the science, about that the question, could be film art? Or is film just the preservation of reality and is not an artistic thing? And I think it's a little bit the same now with virtual reality, because there's a new medium and there will be a lot of discussion in the future about art. And what we had is he had like some theories about why movies could be art. And the first of one was, he was saying the picture changes from the 3D world, from the reality to a 2D world. So you have to choose what you see, and now the artist come inside and the storyteller come inside because he chooses what you have to see. The same with the picture you framed. You can't see all of it. You can't see it like in the real mm-hmm. world. You really mm-hmm. see the framed picture. And if I show just the head, it tells something different than if I show the whole body, for example, of an actor. So about the framing and the picture taking as an art, he say, okay, this is the point where we say film is an art. Then he also say, because he was working with black and white, that the black and white is an art and color would be destroying this art. Also natural light at this time, you had natural light, but the cameras was not so good, so you have always take more lights to the set. And then there was a lighting director, so it was also an artist coming to the space to make a special lightning. And then he said, there's no art is because of the editing. I don't think he was thinking about Victoria or something like this. For him, a movie has to be edited because then you have a new art. It's away from the reality. And then he also was a lot against sound in the movie. He was really, really against it. And also he said, okay, you don't have sound, you don't have smell, you don't have taste, you don't have touch. So this is why movies are art. And of course, he was not white. Eraserhead, imagine this movie without sound. It's not possible because in this movie, the sound is the art in a way. So of course his theory was from the 30s, and the film artists they prove that he is wrong in a way. And also with the color, Apocalypse Now is a big piece of art. It's really immersive, it's really great, and I don't want to watch it in black and white. I really love the colors and how the director chooses it. So you can say, okay, he was not white at the moment. So, but when we look to VR, it's a little bit complicated because all the points, they are not really inside VR. We have 3D worlds. So the picture is not changed to 2D. You have 3D, so also you don't have a framed picture. The people can choose where they want to look. So there's also color, natural light, and editing. You can edit in VR, but in a way, VR is really strong if it's unedited, if it's real, if it feels real. And also, yes, you have sound. Okay, you don't have smell at the moment, taste or touch, but what we really want with VR is that we have some smell, that we have some touch, and maybe some taste. This is also a target. So where could be the new art form of VR is one of the questions. And I think one of the things is the interactivity. I put it like Pac-Man is one of the very old games. And for me, VR is something about interactivity. So the interactivity part is really what makes really strong and gives me a completely new medium where I can have new experiences. And then I have something to show. It's from a movie, because as a filmmaker, it's really complicated for me because I'm not a game maker in a way. So I was thinking, how could combine the things I learn, I use, and the things that the new medium have. And let's see if it works. This one is a game.
About taking that bottle back for the pot.
You can see it. It's a computer game, and it's in a tradition of computer games that try to combine like computer-generated images with film images. Like, you see, they have real actors inside, and a story, and at some points you can choose where the story is going on. So I was thinking, okay, maybe this could be something between the both mediums, which be really interesting to explore into VR. And sorry, you don't understand. It's not loud enough, but then we started to think about how what can I do for projects? We have and we started to let's see. So you have 360 video. Mm-hmm. So you talked about it a little bit. This is one of the biggest thing at the moment because it's the easiest way to record content. Because creating 3D words is always difficult. So you just take cameras, go out and filming. But in a way, it's not really interactive. Because you have a film and you are not able to walk around in this world you created. You, in a way, you just recorded the world like they did it in the past with a theater. Well, it's a little bit like the same. You record the theater play and now you record a 360 video, which is not new. I remember when I was a kid, we went to a holiday park and there was a big dome and you were standing there and there was a roller coaster and you can look around. So it's not a new medium to record a video or where you can look around. This is not the new thing. And what we try, the first project we did was like to make a detective story with interaction and video. So what we did is that you have a 360 video and at some point you can choose points where you can tell where the story is going on. You can say, you will see it now, later. Okay, it's a little bit rough because it's really complicated to make screen capturing of a phone and there are a lot of technical issues to solve in the future. And now you see you can choose if you want to drink the alcohol or you want to drink the water. And depending on that, the story is going on. And also the story has four different endings. And because the theme here is about VR beyond games, the question is it a game or is it a movie or what it is? For me, I think every VR experience in a way is a game because for me, a game is not just a computer game. A game is a play. Spiel in German, and it doesn't have to be a shooter or something. It just talk to me and say, give me something. Yeah, it's a play about me and the person who tells the game. And this is why I think this is the biggest power there. But then we have problems with content, because we want to have 3D words, we want to have people in the 3D words, and maybe we want to move in these words, but as you told, there's a big discussion, only computer generated is virtually or not. And I think this video is from Microsoft and it's a research program. And what they did, they recorded real actors in 3D. So you have real actors, you have a lot of cameras and a lot of software in the computer program to record them. And also there's the question, is this computer generated images or is it not computer generated images? Because in a way that they are real actors, they are normal cameras, but you see a lot of software is used to get this content. And I think in the future there will be a mixed up because at one point you don't know anymore if this is computer generated or not. This project is really interesting for the future because this could solve the problem of moving images or films in which I could move. And so this is a really interesting technique. You can't use it at the moment, really, but we will see it in the future very fast. Because on the way, it's a really easy way at the end to make content, also for journalists, because all the other content is much more difficult to get. Also, you have this this nice photo, and I talked to Linda, and she said, yes.
Maybe just a question here.
Yeah. I think it's a full move video, and they did it for the HoloLens, and it's just to make content. They don't have a real name for it, but later maybe I can give you the YouTube link. They posted on YouTube, but so this one also is a nice picture, but this was really shot with a camera, so. What we want is this, create this world. And this one is, do you know Winewood? This is from GTA. And for me, GTA would be the best virtual reality experience. Because how the fuck I want to walk there? And not about just the shooting, about walk in the big city, collecting all the graffiti in every corner, there's something happened, and another graffiti, there are cats and dogs who can walk around and look at them and everything. So it's a big, big world, but everybody knows it was 1 billion to produce it. So we have a big problem at the moment that the cool 3D worlds are really, really expensive. So one thing to solve it could be in a little bit is photogrammetry. Now I start a little bit more technical. This is a way to get really cool 3D models, realistic models without working too much time on it, because you make recordings of photos. You make a lot of photos from every different angle, and then you have a software who's stitching it together, and you have a 3D model with real textures, because you really see it's an old building, there was like 100 years, there was sand and wind and rain on the surface, so it's a really special surface, and you really record it, because otherwise you need some artist who make it virtual, the 100 years virtual, and it costs a lot of money and time. So this could be a nice way to get good 3D content at the end. And one other is percentual modeling. This is where you take software to make created words without really building it up. You have algorithm. You say, okay, I want to have a word, and I want to have a street there and a building, and then I want to have there's also software you say, okay, I want now that there's a big rain, and then we see how it looks the world after it. So I think there's a big future into this algorithms who creates world with computer software and creates physical simulations. And so and next thing is motion capturing. I think most of you know, like Lord of the Rings was made with a lot of motion capturing and the big studio and everything. And of course, this is not possible for journalists, for example. We saw the Syria demo, and the 3D characters, they didn't look real. So, and they will never have the money to make them looking real. So but there's some technique outside to get something like in Gravity, they made it like the astronaut is in 3D character, but the face is filmed. And I think this is also a really, really interesting thing. We do it now. At the moment, we do a ZDF Heute journal television VR experiment for the ZDF Heute journal, and we make the Mars landing. And this is what we do. We build the character, the astronaut suits in 3D, and animated with motion capturing. But then we filming the people, the faces in 3D, and stitch it together. So you get a feeling, because facial animation is a really, really hard thing. And for this, you can use a special mocap system. You have mocap systems which are video based, And we you can also use mocap system with a initial sensor based, so you have some sensors on your body and it takes your movement. And yeah. And at last I want to invite you. Tomorrow we make a VR jam in Kreuzberg. And what we want to do is just invite some people who want to working on this field, who want to experimenting on this field, and to find out what new possibilities are there. So if you are really interested, it's open to everyone, people with technical skills, people without technical skills. At the end, we will see how mixed will it be, and in the best way, there would be getting teams who are trying some stuff and who will working together. So thank you, and do you have questions?